Hi, guys. Now, I am with one of the coolest interviews we got here today, Brent Spiner, and a lot of people get that confused. Would you clarify that one for us?
Well, you got it right, actually. It's Spiner, because there are people who put another N in my name just to make it Spinner, and it won't work. Ultimately, it's always going to come back to Spiner.
All right. Ultimately, come back to Spiner. Now, who is this fabulous actor? Why, he is Data from Next Generation, and that's another one. A lot of people hop back and forth. Why don't you clarify on that one?
Well, because what do they say other than Data?
Data.
Yeah. See, that would be wrong.
So it's Data.
It is Data, because, and for only one reason, in the 178 episodes we did in four feature films, there was not one character who ever called me anything other than Data. So Data would be incorrect.
That is pretty, you know, set in stone right there. Can't argue with that. Now, we're doing an interview right here. That's fine.
Right there.
So tell us, how did you become part of the Star Trek fold? How were you brought into it?
I auditioned. I wasn't brought in. I clawed my way in. I had, you know, 6-7 auditions and, you know, whittled down the field of thousands of hopefuls. And then, you know, finally it was me. I got lucky.
And what was it like playing a character like Data that is always, you know, holding back his emotions? You know, you always have a look of, you look inquisitive all the time.
Yeah.
And, you know, you never really brought it up. It was always just mellow.
I'm sorry, what was your question?
You know, what was it like playing a character like Data?
What was it like playing a character like Data? It wasn't like anything. I mean, it was like doing an acting job. You know, whenever you're acting, you have certain tasks. And I just had specific tasks as Data, and I just tried to accomplish them as best I could.
And was it difficult being mellow in every single episode in the way that your character was?
Well, you know, it was actually very, very natural for me, because, as you can see, I'm a very, very mellow person. And so, it was simple.
All right. And tell us, in the whole run of Next Generation that you were in, were there any particular favorite episodes or scenes that you shot?
You know what? I didn't care for any of it, to be honest with you. I'm not a big fan, but I was very happy to have the job. And I couldn't be more delighted that there are other people who liked it better than I did.
Oh, wow. That is interesting to hear. You know, and you were with this cast for years and years and years. Do you ever keep in touch with any of them?
You know what? They keep calling. I keep trying to avoid them as much as possible. Occasionally, I'll take one of their phone calls, but it's as rarely as possible.
Why is that?
Have you ever eaten with one of them?
Is it like eating with Worf?
Well, it is exactly like eating with Worf, since he was one of them. But yeah, no, it's an ugly thing, so you try to stay away from it if at all possible.
All right. Well, if you weren't such a big fan of Star Trek, why don't we talk about some of your other roles? I mean, you weren't just Data. You also had some film credits, other television shows. You know, you were in Independence Day, and then a more recent show, Threshold, had a marathon going on the other night. Why don't you tell us about some of your other roles?
Well, I don't want to give you my resume, but I do have a question about Independence Day. Why that is never on television?
You know, it's such a great movie. You see it every 4th of July.
Is that right?
Oh, yeah. Fox every 4th of July.
All right. Well, I'll have to watch for it.
And what was it like working on Independence Day?
It was like sliding down a rainbow with thousands of beautiful babies.
You're going to make this difficult, aren't you?
Why is that difficult? I mean, I could sit here and not have an answer for you at all.
Well, that would make it even more difficult.
Well, of course. When I say, that was a euphemism, by the way, sliding down a rainbow with thousands of beautiful babies, to say it was a wonderful experience. Or I could say it like that. That was a wonderful experience. But how boring is that?
Well, did you interact with any of the other cast at all while you were working with them? You know, so the real big names like Will Smith?
Well, I did meet Will Smith, but at the time, I only knew him as the Fresh Prince. And he's gone on to do other things since then, I'm told, but I haven't run into
Maybe.
Him yet. Yeah.
Now, we are getting questions from our viewers right now, and they would actually like to know if you're going to be doing any voice work for the new big, giant Star Trek MMO that's coming out.
Star Trek what?
Massively multiplayer online game.
Oh, I didn't even know there was one, but they have not contacted me yet. I'm sure they're looking for my number right now. Maybe I should announce it right here on the air. No, I won't do that.
Do you play any games at all?
No, but my son does.
Well, why don't you tell us about your son and the games that he likes to play?
Well, he's a Wii man. you know. He's Wii himself because he's a little boy, and he likes to play Wii, but mostly Wii Lego. Lego Star Wars. He's a big Star Wars fan. And Lego's Batman, Lego's Indiana Jones, that's kind of his area, the Lego area.
So how old is he?
He's seven.
He's seven. So then it is perfectly fine that he plays all those Lego games. Do you ever feel maybe betrayed a little bit when you see him playing all the Star Wars games and you're a Trek guy?
You know, I really don't. I mean, to each his own, right?
Yeah, understandably. And tell us about the Star Trek movies that you were in.
Well, what do you want me to tell you exactly? I mean, I could just start talking about the first day of shooting on these movies and go on for about 3 years, but
well,
I don't know what you
give
mean.
Give us a little bit about what it was like shooting the movies compared to the series and how you felt about the movies in general.
Well, I felt fine about them. The biggest difference, it was kind of the same. We had better craft service on the movies. The food was better. And on the TV series, our mothers had to make our costumes. But in the movies, they were actually professionally made.
So you're a really witty guy. I mean, it's a lot of fun talking to you, and you know you're quick with these jokes here. Did you ever crack jokes during the filming of Star Trek and just completely catch people off guard?
No, I'm a very serious man when I'm working.
Okay.
As you are, I can see.
Well, I'm trying to be.
Yeah. No. I try to be as serious as possible while I'm working, and. I don't joke around. There's no joking. And we never laughed once in 7 years on that set.
I know that to be completely untrue.
Well, if that's the case, why didn't you answer for me?
Not you in particular, but I know the other actors had some great bloopers.
Yeah, no, I don't. You never see a blooper on me because...
Yeah, no, I haven't noticed any.
Yeah, I work very, very diligently.
But that Patrick Stewart, what was he like to work with?
Very difficult. Very difficult person. He, the man actually, we are required to call him Sir Patrick when we work with him.
Are you dead serious?
Well, I've never been dead serious. I don't know what you're talking about, but no. Patrick is a wonderful human being and one of my best friends, and I take the, you know what, out of him.
Right. Well, take the piss. You can say take the piss here.
There are children watching this.
Okay, if you'd like to go that route, that's fine.
Yeah, I see. Is Mickey Dolenz on next?
Mickey Dolenz is on next, I believe. And
I'm a huge Monkees fan. You know, did you ever see the Monkees? Ask him about the Monkee movie Head.
We can.
The Monkees movie Head was written by Jack Nicholson. It's directed by Bob Raffleson, who did Five Easy Pieces.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's better than A Hard Day's Night, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, there are a couple of things that you actually wanted to do here. You said that there was a shout-out that you wanted
to
give.
I'm kind of looking at myself on a monitor there and really kind of shocked at how good I look. Wow. All right, go ahead.
There was a shout-out that you wanted to give. You told me, whatever you do, let me give
you a shout-out.
You know
what? It was just a word I wanted to say, which is thwack.
Thwack. Thwack. Great. So now let us know what's new in your career. Go ahead, plug your website, and we'll wrap it up.
I do have a website, therealbrentspiner.com. Does anybody watch this?
Oh, tons.
I mean, so it's actually worth doing this, right?
Absolutely. We are here at the request of Wizard. If we weren't any good, Wizard wouldn't ask us to be here.
All right. Therealbrentspiner.com, where you can find my CD, Dreamland, which is pretty good, I have to say. And any other projects that I could tell you about are completely secret right now, and... I'm sure you know I would have to kill you if I told you about them, so I'm not going to do that.
And I'm sure you're much stronger than me. Thank you very much for this illuminating, fun, and quite catty interview. And Brent Spiner, thanks a lot, and back to you guys.